the menu is really important because it's going to make us navigate more inside a tab. So for that, you can see that the button is at the right and we got the title for the header. So how is that going to be effective? Let's create a new header. Okay, in the profile section, then let's put a title in here, a bar title. Okay, in the header, and then we'll push our menu button, which is just here. Okay, so let's check profile one. Here it is. But as you can see, it does not behave that well. In order to manipulate our menu button as we want, let's use just before a button set. A button set, it's a bit like the toolbar. It's gonna make us able to place our menu where we want. It's better. Just let me add some text in the bar title so we can see it actually. And here I can see a strange behavior, and it's because I did not follow my first principle, always put toolbars. So you see here in my headers, I don't have any toolbar. That's lame. So let's put the toolbar because it's super powerful. Perfectly, directly in header. And then we put everything in the toolbar. So the header is the first box, second box toolbar. Inside it, I got another box, button set, which is a menu button. And this menu button, I'm going to position it to the right, which means end here and here. It's better. And maybe my title will be just a bit smaller. Okay. So that's good for setting up this header bar. But what is interesting now is to use the menu button. When you click on the menu, you can see you have access to all kind of other pages. And actually, it's all the page I created earlier. So the feed, the discover, and on. Where is that menu created? Just before I keep going, I'm just gonna, Control S, Command S to save all my work, because if my computer crash, I will just be laying down crying. And now after pages, I can go in menu, and there I got access to my menu. So I can see my menu title. I can see the different pages in my menu. So there is a list automatically generated. But here, what I'm going to do is to make a custom list. So better than this, I'm going to just delete the automated generation and put some items. Okay, simply put some text inside. And now you can see my item just changed, so I can customize my menu where, when, how I want, like I want. I can change the fact that it's sliding from the left, but what if I want it to slide from the right because my menu icon is on the right? So I find it makes more sense. I just change the property for my menu, and I'm going to check for swiping from which side. The side is end. Okay, so I'm letting it refresh, and now just it's on the side. Perfect. So here is how I got my menu. From here, I can navigate to different pages. I just have to put pages I want here, simply, and then change the page where they go. A bit like my tab bars earlier. And that's it for headers, folks. Next is a big one, which is the grid. Let's see that.